Divine presence in Gopi Thalab. The word Thalab means a tank. Gopi Thalab signifies Gopi tank. It is also known as Vasu Devhrata, implying a tank of Gopi Chandana. Apart from the availability of Gopi Chandana in that sacred tank, there is another reason too for its getting the name Gopi tank. Presently, a sweeping survey of the eye will reveal the entire spread of the tank. But in ancient times, this water reserve should have been of very vast coverage beyond the normal human vision. Yes, if 16,108 persons should have then amused themselves in the tank at one and the same time, it could be imagined how large the reservoir would have been. In fact, that is the reason for Gopi Chandana being found not only in the tank but also in the area proximate to it. Why Gopi Chandana is procurable from this tank alone and what its speciality is are queer things beyond the reach of science. In the earlier chapter, the pits resulting from sand quarrying in the riverbed was explained, and in contrast to it, the perennial source of the Gopi Chandana in the Gopi Thalab was touched upon in the passing. Viewing in a different perspective, this strange phenomenon left me baffled and in great wonderment when I was standing there and surveying the surroundings. In Neyveli, I once had the opportunity of seeing how lignite is dug out by the mining process. The earth excavated in the process is heaped in mounds, and the water gushing out in the operation is diverted for irrigation. The workforce will move to another spot when the job is over in one mining area, closing the voidness there with the mass of earth piled up nearby or accumulating in the day-to-day operations. The process goes on, thus covering a large area. With no lignite deposits being available for excavation from the places already exploited. But Gopi Chandana excavation is not like lignite mining. It is to be found in the sacred tank, even after excavation, getting replenished periodically, a cyclical phenomenon occurring to this day. Beyond a certain limit, bordering the Gopi Thalab, only ordinary soil will come out when the earth is dug up. Not the sacred Gopi Chandana. Truly, the availability of Gopi Chandana now in that vast area where 16,108 gopis, the women cowherds charmed by Sri Krishna, had been sporting in the water of a tank that had existed there in the distant past is something amazing. I was visualizing the events of that bygone era while standing on the bank of the Gopi Thalab. Totally unaware then of the happenings around me, I could see small blocks of Gopi Chandana on the bank of the sacred tank also. My heart was pining to get into the waters and fetch outside some quantity of Gopi Chandana. But I consoled myself that I could make another visit to the place when the water dries up. Yes. If Sri Hari Vayu Guru is prayed to with sincerity and devotion, our desires will surely be fulfilled by divine grace. I am sanguine that I shall be blessed to visit the place again when the tank is dry, affording me the opportunity of seeing the operation of digging out Gopi Chandana when in full swing. On the bank of Gopi Thalab, there is a Gopinatha temple. It's an ancient one with raised walls around it and a small sanctum inside. At the same place, there is a small Gopika shrine also. One may wonder whether the tank got its name as Gopi Thalab because 16,108 gopis had indulged in Rasa Krida there, sporting in its water with the Lord, or for the reason that Lord Gopinatha is ensconced there. Of course, both are attributable. But as seen earlier, if the find of Gopi Chandana is the plausible reason, what follows later is yet another justification. Sri Madhvacharya has enlightened in Sri Krishnamrita Maharnava that the Chandana, sandal paste, which the gopis had levigated and applied on the divine body of Sri Krishna is of supreme sanctity, and as such, the gifting of the sacred Gopi Chandana to Brahmins, even in small quantity, will ensure the prosperity of 7 generations of the one proffering it. And since Gopi Chandana Dana gifting has such inherent merit in it, at least once in a month such proffering should be put into practice by the devout ones. Sriman Madhvacharya has described Gopi Chandana as the sandal paste made by the gopis and anointed on the person of Sri Krishna. Therefore, it had presumably spilled at that spot and mixed with mud, giving room for the surmise that the sanctity of the clay and of the place of its existence has been acquired by such divine orchestration. But more importantly, its holiness is attributable to the divine presence of the Lord in Gopi Thalab. When I examine this aspect in depth, I heard 2 Puranic stories recounted about it, and some notations about them are contained also in the available historical information on that sacred place. One legend runs that the Lord used to have his holy bath on the Shravana Ekadashi day in different Teethas, and once the gopis were captivated by an enchanting sarovara, pool or tank, created by Mayavimai, and prayed to the Lord to get one like that contrived for them too. The Lord accordingly ordained Vishwakarma to design and create an alluring sarovara, which was compiled with by the divine architect, and it is that sacred tank which now carries the name Gopi Thalab. It's also said that the Lord had also proclaimed that the sarovara created will always be having his divine presence in it. Another story relates that Bhaumasura Raja had once seized the umbrella of Varuna, the kundala, ear ornament of Atithi, the mound of gems in Mount Meru and the like. Angered by it, Indra approached the Lord for redressal, in consequence of which the Lord annihilated Bhaumasura after a fight with him. In the palace of Bhaumasura, several princesses, beautiful women and virgin girls were found to be held captive, and they all felt extremely joyous at seeing the Lord and learning about the extinction of the tyrant. Each one of those liberated women showed preference for the Lord to be her consort, and the Almighty, accepting them all, sported with them at that place, and it is that spot which now stands identified as Gopi Thalab. Whatever be the legendary background, it is the divine influence radiant at that place that has rendered the Gopi Thalab an inexhaustible source of the sacred Gopi Chandana that the holy tank is yielding unceasingly, even as the digging there is carried on without pause. I was excited to walk along the bank of such sacred tank and sprinkled its holy water on my head, getting down to the edge of the tank. The bluish water of the Thalab and the cool breeze blowing there was most pleasing in that ambience. I visualized there the scene of Lord Krishna playing water sport with the gopis in the vast stretch of water existent there at that time. Artist Sashi, after seeing the video pictures of Gopi Thalab, has by his artistic skill presented in this a lovely pencil sketch of the Gopika women of with Sri Krishna that portrays a portion of the tank. The Gopi Chandana that has the divine presence of the Lord in it should be applied on one's person with concentration and devotion, uttering the God's name while applying each Nama. There are very few who sport the Gopi Chandana marks in the proper way. The Dwadash Namas, when applied on the body, will carry more benefit if the prescribed procedures are followed. The next few pages will throw light on the methodology to be followed for the proper marking of the religious Namas, which present a rather unique appearance on Sri Raghavendra Swami in the pictures depicting him.